So this is where we are in the story.
God made a perfect world, but people messed it up. They chose not to love and obey God.
But some people still make good choices, like three guys who had really strange names.
Shadrach,
Meshach, and Abednego.
They were Daniel's friends.
Remember? He's the guy that spent the night in the lion's den.
They were really important because they worked for the king.
His name was Nebuchadnezzar.
Try to say that three times fast.
Nebuchadnezzar, Nebuchadnezzar, Nebuchadnezzar.
They decided to make a huge statue out of gold.
It would be really tall so everyone could see it.
And every time the people heard trumpets,
everyone had to stop what they were doing and pray to the giant statue. If they didn't,
they would get thrown in a fiery furnace.
It was like a huge fireplace.
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego knew God
and knew they shouldn't pray to anyone else.
No one else.
He said so himself. So when everyone else bowed to the statue to pray,
they did not.
And people noticed. It was a big deal.
The king was furious.
But he decided to give them a second chance. They told the king,
"We haven't changed our minds.
If you throw us in the fire, God can save us.
And if he doesn't, we still won't pray to your statue."
The king was furious.
He had them in handcuffs.
He told his guards to turn the heat up in the furnace.
And threw them inside.
Things were not looking good for them.
But after a few minutes,
the king looked inside the furnace,
and guess what he saw?
Four guys.
Just walking around.
Not hurt at all.
And who was that fourth guy?
The king went to the furnace and yelled,
"Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, come out here!"
And they walked out of the fire.
They weren't burned at all. They didn't even smell like smoke.
The king was shocked.
He changed his mind right then and there.
And he said no one could say anything bad about God,
because God was so good.
Then he said,
"No God has ever pulled off a rescue like this."
And you know what?
Later, God would pull off another great rescue.
But that's another part of the story.